My research points to a cure, almost too amazing to fathom, but I must try and I must succeed. It will require going into the heart of Melsavis.
Someone is manipulating this war. Someone who destroyed the Shadow Arsenal and Eisen 4, who gave the SIS your keyword. I need you to find these invisible agents before they do something catastrophic.
Billions of simultaneous deaths. He seeks to commit genocide on Belsavis.
That prison world holds the worst filth captured by the Republic. Mass murderers, tyrants, even captured Sith Lords.
Apprentice, it is customary to bow when in the presence of a member of the Dark Council.
Don't hold your breath.
I will tolerate such obstinacy in private, young one. Bow to me while in the presence of outsiders, or you will be punished severely. Am I understood?
I didn't mean to anger you, Master.
Rise, my faithful servant. We are at war. The Dark Council has placed me in charge, and battles are being waged across the galaxy. You and Lord Drog will oversee the most crucial confrontations. Drog is already deployed, and now I shall unleash you.
Where am I being sent?
We've caught wind of a secret plot on the planet Quesh that could win the planet for the Republic. The conflict for resources on Quesh remains the most important of the fringe systems. This Republic plot must not succeed.
That's where I caught up to General Monk.
Ancient history now. Commander Olian will brief you. He awaits your arrival at the forward command center on Quesh. I find myself nostalgic, sending my most prized apprentice off to war. This is the culmination of everything we've done.
The poignancy of this moment is not lost on me, Master.
Poignancy? You've hit on the perfect word to describe where we are, my friend. I bid you farewell.
My lord, I am applying to receive the trials for the rank of captain, second grade. I formally submit a request for your recommendation.
You will succeed or fail on your own credentials, not my influence.
You're right. Thank you, my lord. Your wisdom is considerable.
What's on your mind, Ved?
I've been talking to Teeva. First thing she did after you freed her was start trying to find Mother. I'm helping where I can.
How goes the search?
Aggravating. Standard Imperial databases aren't any help. Mother wasn't that old when she had us. She has to be alive. Somewhere. Anyway, mainly wanted to thank you for Teeva. It's sad that nobody else sees what a good person you are inside.
It's so amusing to think I was once training to be a Jedi. You're opening me up to my true potential. I feel such power surging through me.
I'm impressed with how well you're absorbing all my various influences.
Ready for more whenever you are. Dear, there will be no stopping us.
No, I've said this before, but I kept my mouth shut for a while now. Time to speak up. Quinn's dead weight. Can't do anything without his approval. He's slowing us both down.
Salute the captain and move on. The only command you need obey is mine.
Appreciate it. Just want to give 110% here. One crew can make or break a mission. In Black Ops, everyone knows their job and does it. No room for screw-ups. We were the go-to squad. Assassination of Moff Tarek. The massacre at Harun Kal. Operation Force Crush. All us.
What happened to your Black Ops team?
Treaty of Khorasan. Black Ops was disbanded. Everyone reassigned. Dumb move. Good team. Hitting the right targets. We were gearing up for some serious assaults before we were shut down. Like the Bastion. Huge Republic military complex on Corellia. They say it can't be taken. We would have done it.
The Empire will reach the Bastion eventually.
Need clearance first, and the rest of the team to pull it off. Should get back to work. Bend your ear about this long enough.
Time for death, Twi'lek.
Kava dupa stumpa, my king, sir! Quiet, both of you. You know your trial. Now go. My lord, you just missed the latest trial. As you can see, we have a wild group. All except the human. He was surprisingly quick to die.
The trials are meant to separate the weak from the strong.
You have come a long way, my lord. My credits are on the three-eyed one, personally. Uglier than my twisted Sith grandmother, but he has a vicious streak uncommon in slaves.
I'll take that bet. My credits are on the Kalish.
I didn't know you were the gambling type, my lord. While you're here, is there anything particular you want to accomplish with these trials? Many Sith lords use the acolytes to gather things from the tombs for them.
Anything that will help me in my struggle with Thanaton would be appreciated.
I think I know something. I'll contact you when they are on their last trial so that you can arrive in time for the results.
Zash and I have been looking over the information you recovered from Thanaton's library.
Any truth to the rumors there's a big old Republic prison on Delsavis?
I heard something of that from Master Ryan, but I didn't want to believe it.
Unfortunately, Delsavis looks like the most promising lead. Darth Eradus went there seeking a cure for the deterioration of his body. It sounds like precisely the thing you need.
Then let's set a course for Belsavis.
My knowledge is limited, but I'll brief you once we dock with the Belsavis space station.
My lord, I must ask a favor of you. Our mission. We cannot hope to accomplish it without help.
I'm afraid we won't get much support from the Sith.
Not the Sith. The Jedi. Yes, I know. There are Jedi who would help us. Who would see that a strong, rational empire is the only path to peace.
Clearly, you have a particular Jedi in mind.
Master Simon Walls is known by many as a wise, open-minded Jedi. He brought the Sith Lord Karras Vale to the light and oversaw his initiation into the Jedi. He has retired in seclusion to Alderaan for personal study and meditation, but young Jedi still make pilgrimages to him. I would like to make a pilgrimage, and if possible, get his support.
I welcome any support we can get.
I'll return quickly, I promise.
You'll never believe what I found. I thought I'd left this behind planets ago.
Is it some kind of artifact?
This is the tooth of a 4,000-year-old proto-rancor. But look, see this? It's some kind of metal. Not cortosis, but very similar. This rancor was tamed. It was my very first discovery. I carry it with me everywhere for luck. I thought I'd lost it when I fell into an old tomb a couple of digs ago. It turned out it was caught in the lining of my pocket.
On Korriban, I pulled an artifact from an ancient holocron that was supposed to be unopenable.
You mean from the pyramid and the tomb of Mark Aragnos? How did you do it? With a sonic excavator or some device of your own?
It was painfully obvious, really. I used lightning.
Just open, damn it!
You know, there's a theory in the archaeological world that certain ancient devices, holocrons especially, have resonances. It's something to do with the Force. Just as only Sith can activate holocrons, some ancient devices can only be activated by certain Sith bloodlines. Well, most archaeologists reject it as unscientific. But there's so much about the galaxy we don't understand. Who am I to say what's scientific?
I'm not one to dismiss an idea just because it seems a little crazy.
Oh, yes, my lord. I thought so. But if you'll excuse me, I have some new findings to analyze.
This is Watcher 6 to Cipher 9. Initial target assessment is complete. Recommend you proceed to Planet Belsavis for operational briefing.
On my way. Any details yet?
My conclusions would be misleading. Uploading hyperspace coordinates and new security codes. Be aware that in times of war, clearance must be reconfigured every 6 hours. Watcher 6 out.
This whole conspiracy tripe, you really think we're gonna find something?
I think prudence is a virtue in times like these.
They sent a summary briefing file, sir. Whatever you need, we'll be ready.
You haven't had it easy since coming on board. everything that's happened.
Oh, I haven't followed half of it, but I'm committed to trying.
Yeah, all right. Strap in.
Sir, since our combat session went so well, I thought we might try something else. Lessons in interpersonal manipulation and information extraction. Lecture 1, entitled...
Once they think they need you, they'll tell you anything.
Descriptive name, sir. Is it always about need? When I first arrived at Zero Station, no one trusted me. I was the human Imperial who must have been a spy. But I learned my way around. And once the Chiss accepted my competence, it was easy to make friends.
Not all your marks will be as pleasant as the Chiss.
So suppose we're separated during an operation against pirates, say. How does your hand-trained operative play it?
You blend into the background and wait for an opportunity. Don't stir the pot unless you know what you're in for.
I'll happily leave that to you, then. I don't know what you think of my potential, sir, but I do appreciate your guidance. I've been deceiving people like an amateur for years. Time I started doing it right.
Doctor, you wanted to talk.
Yes, and I'm terribly sorry to take your time. But I have a small request. To be frank, it's a bit of an embarrassment.
If you need to start feeding on humanoid blood, I don't think I can arrange it.
You almost sound like you disapprove. It's nothing of the sort. I told you before about my safe houses, how my intruder alarms have been going off. Well, I attributed it to local happenstance. I may have been mistaken. My safe house on Balmora exploded.
Any idea who among your enemies is responsible?
I could theorize regarding who did this and why, but truthfully, all I know is someone bypassed Imperial security to get inside. I'll need to see the safe house in person. I'll return as soon as I can.
You could be walking into a trap. Stay alert, Doctor.
And you.
Agent, you recall we spoke to the diplomatic service about building an alliance between Empire and Kilix? Falna Eth, the man who offered his backing in return for our assistance, has asked us for his first favor.
What's our diplomat friend after?
Falna wants our notes on various families and unaligned worlds in the Questal sector. He means to bring that sector into the Empire. We worked in Questal a long while, and we knew its people well. It's odd to see someone else take the reins.
You don't talk about your old life.
We don't often have a reason to think about it. We do miss negotiating, reaching out to understand people, synthesizing their needs. Dizana of the Lesai Nest says that desire makes us a better joiner. It's only small comfort.
You haven't forgotten your training. Even as Dawn Herald, you're an ambassador.
Perhaps. But seeing men like Falna again, we think it's best if he handles negotiations. Apologies, Agent. This is something we need to think on more deeply. But we are glad you stand by us.
This is headquarters to Cypher 9, clearing your arrival with station control.
Cypher, you're now orbiting 40,000 kilometers above Bell Service, the Republic's largest penal colony. Fancy rebuilding your criminal reputation?
I thought you swapped your sense of humor for the promotion.
Only in part. Proceed, Watcher 3.
Balsavis Prison was built in secret to hold the galaxy's most dangerous individuals. 3 main levels, thousands of specialized cell blocks holding everyone from changelings to Sith Lords.
We've known of the prison's existence for nearly a year. Now we understand that the conspirators subverted Balsavis to their own use.
You sound pretty confident given the circumstances.
It's all about following the record trail.
The conspirators pulled strings with Republic higher-ups to construct a special section, Mega Security Ward 23. It's somewhere past the alien cells and the genocide ward. They built it and sealed it when Balsavis was founded. No one gets inside.
It's the highest security area of the best protected prison in the galaxy. You're going to break in and find what it's hiding.
Lay out our resources. How do we do this?
2 decades ago, a prison gang heard about the ward and tried to breach it, hoping something inside would help them escape.
Thieves, security experts, the underworld's best. None of them made it back. But they had the right idea.
You'll assemble your own gang from the prison. Establish yourself as a fellow inmate and succeed where the last group failed.
Anyone particular in mind for my gang?
You'll find supplies and a detailed dossier at our outpost on the planet's surface.
Our military forces are encouraging riots as part of the war effort. It's distracting the Republic and should conceal your operation. But don't be mistaken. The prisoners are not grateful. Keep out.
I can't believe him! I'm not a Jedi. He says I'm not a Jedi?
Who are you talking about?
Master Simon!
I came to him for help, and he turned me away.
It's not fair. I was the best Padawan Masters Ryan and Osera ever trained. I am a Jedi.
You're reacting like a Sith.
The Sith are murderers. I know what's right. It's not evil. It can't be. The return of the Sith in this war has changed things. Sometimes compromise is necessary. Yes, I don't care what Master Simon said. Thank you, my lord, for helping me talk through this.
We've arrived at the Belsavis spaceport.
Good. We'll have to work quickly if we're to find a cure for your strange ailment. We know that a Sith called Darth Eratos suffered a similar problem. His power became too much for him, and he began to deteriorate. We also know that he went to Belsavis in search of a recovered device that he believed could fix him, whatever that means.
Who were these Rakata?
Little is known of them. They were highly advanced and ruled the galaxy. Then they just disappeared. I've looked into Belsavis. There is indeed evidence that the Rakata were here, and that they built some kind of monumental prison.
The Rakata on Belsavis? My friend, you trade in myths and wonders! Myths and wonders!
The Republic have arrived since, however, and built their own prison. Whatever this device is, we'll have to navigate two prisons to get to it.
I'll destroy that prison piece by piece, if I have to.
Fortunately, that work has already begun. The Empire recently discovered the Republic's prison and staged a massive prison break.
Saves us the trouble of breaking in, I guess.
It also means the planet is in chaos, and any trail Darth Eratos left will have been obliterated.
I wonder what the Empire wants with Belsavis. It seems rather out of the way.
I'm afraid I've been out of the loop too long to say. But while perusing the Republic prison logs, I discovered a familiar name. The Circle, a group of criminal technologists Nikto I once employed. They never met a system they couldn't slice, or a machine they couldn't reverse engineer. Perhaps they can interpret Darth Eratus' diagrams on Belsavis.
Do you know where they were being held?
Unfortunately, no.
I bet one of the guardhouses has a record of where they were kept. I've seen my share of prisons.
We must be careful. Belsavis is a place of unknown danger. But be quick. The dates on Darth Eratus' records show his condition worsening rapidly.
Well, I'm afraid the news is mixed. My safe house did, indeed, burn to the ground, along with three would-be assassins who were attempting to wire it with explosives. Apparently, my security triggered their bombs prematurely.
You booby-trap all your safe houses? Or just the ones your enemies know about?
You make it sound like I used safe houses as bait. I did acquire genetic samples of the intruders. I'll be running traces shortly. One was a human male. The others, uncertain. Regardless, they used Imperial equipment and codes to get inside. Someone in the Empire wants me dead.
This could be a frame job. It wouldn't be hard to arrange.
A wise assertion, although the particulars suggest otherwise. One way or the other, I take comfort in the fact that I'm once again viewed as a threat. My days in retirement are over.
Kiperum, chin nampa al anam, netnikum. Laporam amga, mamni nikag. Nagnaya mamni kamgam.
I'll have a little chat with him then.
Anang nimu, kemgam kara yangma.
Approach. You have garnered the attention of my master, the Emperor. He foresees you performing great deeds on Belsavis, and he sends this message. Do not disappoint him.
People call me Lord. you should as well.
The Imperial Guard speak with the Emperor's command. We bow to no other. That said, welcome to Belsavis. This planet holds the Republic's dirtiest secret, a maximum security prison home to the galaxy's most depraved convicts. We've come to free them. Specifically, the Dread Masters, Elder Sith who could change the course of the war.
The Empire's risking much to free these Sith. Why?
The Dread Masters possess the unique ability to cripple an entire enemy force with terror. We've deployed special operations groups to release them. They freed prisoners and sparked riots. But during the chaos, we lost contact with all five teams. You will need to re-establish contact, and, if necessary, relaunch the operation to free the Dread Masters.
I like the idea of Sith Lords owing their freedom to me.
The shuttle will drop you at the last known location of Operations Group 5. Find Lord Medishus. Help him fan the flames of the riot. Minimum resources, maximum results. That's how we avoid disappointing the Emperor.
Welcome, my lord. I assumed Commander Callum sent you to help. I'm Lord Medishus, leader of Operations Group 5. We started this riot by arming prisoners and pointing them at their Republic captors. But our primary goal is to extract certain inmates held deep within the prison.
Commander Callum said they were Sith Lords.
Correct. The Dread Masters. They can reach out through the Force and pierce their enemies with terror. Whole armadas surrender to them without firing a shot. The Republic claimed the Dread Masters were killed in the last war. Returning them to the field would be a crowning achievement.
That'll do nicely.
Free the Dread Masters and you'll find much to your advantage. Unfortunately, the Republic's moved them to the deep prison. Meanwhile, the Warden brought in a hard-headed off-world enforcer, Ellis Ruger. He's here to close our exit corridor. If the Republic isn't stopped, they'll retake this landing zone. Without an exit, our prison break will fail.
I've held off army units. Prison guards will be like wading through dung.
Just the attitude we need to break them. They're cowering behind force fields, sending droids to do their dirty work. These Warden droids have enough firepower to incapacitate a small army. The rioters are losing hope, but we can reignite their rage. Destroy enough droids and the convicts will smell blood. They'll practically defend our landing zone for us.
If a few broken droids will spark the convicts' fury, I'll set this riot ablaze.
Impress the rioters with your power and the droids' weakness. Then they'll fight our enemy for us.
Warden droids are no more. I hope the rioters took note.
Have no fear. Thousands of prisoners already move against the droids. More devotees follow your footsteps every minute. Many have died in the process, but that's normal.
Minimum effort, maximum results, I see.
They will occupy the guards' attention with little more energy on our part. A fine move. Thanks to you, the inmates have turned from whipped dogs into predators. Still, we need more convicts on our side. Turn this mob into an army and the Republic will be permanently occupied. An army begins with generals. We must provide the prisoners with the leadership they require.
Is there a point in all of this?
There's a carbonite storage facility in the intake yards, full of frozen convicts. Some were rebellion leaders, others simply murdered every guard they found. We need both persuasions.
Sounds fast and easy. Leave their rescue to me.
Excellent. I've taken measures to maximize the benefits of this operation. Prisoner, what of your mission into the Carbon Gallery?
The Crisis Response Unit ambushed us. I got away. Only me.
Excellent. Ruger took the bait. Now you can free the frozen prisoners and wipe out the crisis response unit all at once.
I'll be there in but a moment.
Destroy the guards and defrost the prisoners. They'll turn this riot into an organized army. Then we'll have safe passage to extract the Dread Masters.
Major, this is General Garza. I need you to report to my office on Coruscant immediately. General Racton made his move. The Imperials have invaded dozens of Republic planets. Havoc Squad is needed, immediately.
Is there a plan for dealing with this invasion, General?
I'll brief you on the details when you arrive. Move quickly. Garza out.
I have excellent news, sir. Given the rigorous nature of Havoc Squad's missions, my power core has seen extensive use, and its capabilities have increased as a result. I now have access to far greater energy reserves, significantly improving the quality of my service to the Republic.
You must be very proud, Forex.
I am, sir. Please, sir, if I may make a request, let's engage in combat as soon as possible. I'm eager to put my new capabilities to the test. I was wondering about your opinion on Imperial superweapons. Devices that can devastate entire fleets or worlds in a single strike. I find them intriguing.
No one should have weapons that powerful.
That is a popular viewpoint, but I cannot understand it. Surely such devices could see worthwhile use in the defense of freedom. Given these weapons' capabilities, I've been researching Imperial weapon designers to find a worthy target for Havoc Squad. One name stands out above all others, Colonel Rebus, the head of one of the Empire's top weapons research programs. I have located no personal information on Colonel Rebus, not even a physical description. Over the past 2 weeks, however, mentions of his name on Imperial comm channels have increased in frequency by 15.2%. This suggests a project nearing completion.
Where is he?
The location of Colonel Rebus's research lab is one of the most closely guarded secrets in the Empire. No information is available as yet. As soon as I learn more, I'll inform you right away.
I've been looking over the customer files from Magarin's office. The guy really didn't know how to run an outfit. When you're selling guns, you always get the money up front. You only take installments from customers you can grab when they don't pay. Magarin had installment customers all over the galaxy, and big surprise, a lot of them never paid off their bills. Amateur.
I'm surprised Magarin would hire people to go after you, but not his debtors.
He only wanted me dead, and hired killers come cheap these days. Good debt collectors are expensive. You actually have to trust them. There are credits to be made. People owed Magarin. I took him down, which means his stuff is my stuff now. Well, sorry, our stuff. Everyone who owed him owes me now. I'll look through the lists, find the big debts, and collect, and give you a reasonable cut. How's that sound?
Do you really think people will pay?
I think we can persuade just about anyone to pay up.
Sir, I have excellent news. I've secured permission for us to use Form 859RA for our after-action reports, instead of the older 859R.
That's definitely really exciting, Alara.
A 1/6 reduction in form completion time. This should result in a cumulative time savings of more than 90 minutes within 4 weeks. It should be quite pleasant.
We've been through quite a bit, haven't we, sir? Since I joined Havoc Squad, I've seen more combat and performed more medical treatments than in my entire career beforehand. I've learned a great deal.
There's still plenty of work for Havoc to do.
Yes, sir. Plenty of opportunities to improve my skills even further. I couldn't be prouder to be a part of Havoc Squad. I'm serving the Republic and becoming a better soldier and medic every day. And I have you to thank for it all. Most officers would never have given me this chance, but you did. Thank you.
I didn't want Havoc to be all men. The skills are a nice bonus, though.
Very funny. Enough talk. Let's put some of this experience to work, shall we?
A few psychopaths should keep the Republic awake at night.
hope you're proud. Your time on Belsavis is up.
You speak that way to a Sith Lord.
I'd speak this way to the Emperor himself if the coward dared show his face. I've been cracking heads 20 years this spring. Every Sith I've downed thought the law never applied to him. So let me make this perfectly clear. You've made a mistake. Time to pack up and fly home.
You can't scare me off, Ruger. I'm here to stay.
I'll enjoy throwing your stubborn carcass in jail.
There was only enough power to thaw the best prisoners. I unleashed the worst murderers I could find.
The convicts were violent before. With psychopaths at the helm, there's no telling what crimes they'll commit. Ruger will not be pleased.
He called to threaten me. He seemed unafraid.
Ruger's tamed prisons before, even restored order to Coruscant's depths. It's time we end his career.
The only thing keeping us from his throat are the force fields guarding his base. Luckily, a mad Deveronian prisoner, Golan, has the key.
I can get you your key. And the hand holding it.
I almost pity the poor Deveronian, but you should know, Golan is not your average prisoner.
He knows the key is valuable, plus he's trained in the Force and highly violent.
The Republic tried executing him 4 times. That's when they shipped him to Belsavis. Now Golan thinks he can't die. He's refusing to hand over the key to Ruger's guard station.
I can be quite persuasive.
You can try talking to him, but he's more the rip-your-arms-off type. Be ready when you approach. Golan roams near the resettlement camps, in the open areas where wise inmates leave him alone. Make your way there. The longer we delay, the more likely Ruger will change the lock frequency on the security fields.
Master Satil, we've arrived at Belsavis. Have you learned anything?
The Empire just launched a surprise attack there. Dangerous prisoners are free from their cells to wreak havoc down on the surface.
A mere diversion. The Emperor has only one true goal. The annihilation of all life on this world.
Just tell me what to do.
We don't know how the Emperor intends to destroy all life on Belsavis. We do have one lead. Intelligence indicates a high-ranking Imperial named Executor Kranis recently arrived on world.
Kranis is a pure-blooded Sith, fanatically loyal to the Emperor. Whatever the plan is, he's the one tasked with carrying it out.
Do we have any idea where Executor Kranis is now?
N.A. Tabord, a member of our Order, is already on the surface looking for Kranis. She'll help you find the Executor, but she isn't strong enough to stop him. That task falls on you.
If these are the most dangerous criminals in the galaxy, should we just leave them on the loose?
If the Emperor succeeds in his ritual, all life in the galaxy will be extinguished.
What your companion says is true, but Jedi do not turn their backs on those in need. Do not endanger your mission, but do what you can to help the Republic restore order. Go to the planet's surface and meet Enna at the coordinates I'm sending you now. May the Force be with you.
Whoa, hold on. You're the Jedi who was supposed to meet Enna, right? I know what this looks like, but I told her to wait for you. She wanted to go outside, scout the area. I warned her if the Imperials didn't get her, the escaped convicts would. Enna didn't listen.
I want your name and rank, soldier.
I'm not a soldier. Name's Pak Taldeen. I work here. Enna heard I know Belsavis better than anyone and asked me to help her. I had no idea what I was signing up for. And I just want to get out of this alive.
Jedi aren't easy to kill. What happened to Enna?
She crawled back from her scouting mission, wounded and barely alive. Said she escaped from an Imperial patrol. I tried to help her, but I'm not a medtech. She told me everything she learned out there, right up to her last breath. None of it was good news.
I'm looking for an Imperial officer, a red-skinned Sith.
Enna told me the Imperials are entrenched by the main reactor. They were taking orders from a pure-blood Sith. They have heavy weapons and a ray shield protecting their position. Nobody's moving them from that reactor anytime soon.
Why are the Imperials so determined to hold that position?
The reactor controls the security gates. The Imperials are sending troops deeper into the prison and making it impossible for us to follow them. You'll never get past the Imperial shields before their heavy weapons mow you down. We need a plan.
What if we take out the shields?
If you overload the energy relays feeding the sector's power grid, you could knock down that ray shield. We've got ion charges here. We could plant one at each power relay, detonate them simultaneously, and short out the Imperial defenses.
Give me the ion charges. Keep an eye on Enna's remains. See they're treated with respect.
Contact me when all the charges are in place. I'll detonate them from this control room. Good luck, and watch your back.
The ion charges are all in place. Take down that Sith ray shield.
I read you. Detonating the ion charges now. I cleared the way. Now comes the fun part. Taking on Sith heavy weapons. Good luck. I'll be standing by.
Commander Olian, I am here on Darth Barriss's order. Bring me up to speed.
Not a minute too soon. All indications are that the enemy has been ready to strike for some time. If my reports are correct, they have us dead to rights. I'm thankful they've hesitated this long.
They'll regret not seizing the opportunity.
They may yet if we don't hurry. An elite Republic task force has found a cavern that tunnels beneath this command center. They've set explosives that will destroy the center and disrupt all Imperial military operations and communications on the planet.
Only a fool sits and waits for death.
My hands are tied, my lord. Operations here cannot be moved nor abandoned, and all my forces are engaged on the front. I sent what soldiers I had to search the cavern, but the survivors returned with blaster burns for their efforts. Here are rough coordinates of our best guess. Good luck.
Has our mysterious problem been solved? Are we active?
Sir, best guess is yes. All systems appear to be online. Your detonator should be live.
Then let's pack up. We'll blow this cavern on the Imperial Command Center sky high.
You're not going anywhere.
Late. We've been discovered. Stow it. We knew this was a possibility. Sith, I'm prepared to detonate even if it means we all die. You've just wandered into your own funeral. Throwing the switch. What? No, come on, detonate. Detonate! Ah!
Today is not your day.
Men, this mission is everything. It will win Quest for the Republic. We will be immortalized as heroes. I order you to hold off the Sith while I reset the detonator.
There will be no detonation.
Okay. In my humble opinion, this mission is a bust. We'd like to just leave now, please?
Get out of my sight before I kill you.
Leaving!
Well, well, well. Well done. Mission accomplished, eh?
Why are you bothering me?
I have a mission of my own, friend. Captain Trayan was sent here by one of Barriss's Republic moles. The explosives he set up were not wired to the captain's detonator. I have the real detonator. An elaborate trap for you.
So, Barriss is stabbing me in the back.
Our master prides himself on being one step ahead of everyone. That includes you. He knew someday you would rise against him. You were his fiercest. I consider it a privilege that he's allowed me to pull the trigger.
He wouldn't dare face me himself.
The Master never takes out the trash. Barriss sends his regards. Goodbye.
interest justified, shall I revive?
Offer no help. We must be sure. His worth will be established by surviving the trek to safety. We will wait at the command center exactly one day for our proof.
Begin playback. Authorization Cipher 9.
Cipher, this is Infiltration Operative Bax Kohler. I have assembled a list of prisoners with the skills to breach Mega Security Ward 23. This is Gamjan Slyke, assassin and escape artist. His brother died breaking into the ward some years ago. Slyke can reconstruct and reassess his brother's plan. He hates authority figures, Imperials included. Next, Cheney Barrow, slicer and computer expert, former top saboteur for the Exchange. Motivated by greed and known to nurse a grudge. Ota, ex-mercenary and bounty hunter, cast out of the Mandalorians for dishonorable conduct. He'll provide support and demolitions. Lastly, Parkos. No information on his crimes, but he's an alien tracker whose species sees through walls. Handy to have around traps. These people are volatile and extremely dangerous. Present yourself as a fellow inmate. Do not reveal your allegiance.
Burly men and touchy alien freaks. It's like running with the old gang.
Somehow I don't think this group will be together long.
Like I said.
You'll use explosives to free the prisoners. Tag each prison cell with a blasting cap, then head to the Republic Security Center. Use the security consoles to disable any fail-safes and make contact with the prisoners. You can detonate the blasting caps remotely. Maps and safe house coordinates are attached. You're on your own now.
We are impressed. You are worthy to be the Emperor's wrath.
All I want to know is whether you'll help me kill Darth Barriss and Lord Drag.
Our purpose coincides with that desire exactly. Look on me. I am Servant One. This is Servant Two. We are the Emperor's hand. The Dark Council runs blind. We alone oversee the Emperor's will in the galaxy.
What does that have to do with me?
You have been called.
The Emperor tasks the Hand with a great undertaking, and you are to become his wrath. Darth Barriss seizes power against the Emperor's wishes. He must be stopped.
Why do you need me to handle this?
An empty hand can only slap.
Since the Treaty of Coruscant, the Emperor has withdrawn from the known galaxy, preparing for a great calling. Barriss learned of this and now claims the Emperor speaks through him. If the Dark Council declares him the voice of the Emperor, he will have supreme power over the Empire.
What is the voice of the Emperor?
The voice is the conduit for the Emperor's words. The Emperor chooses one being to physically embody. This being is the voice. It is obeyed as the Emperor himself.
But the true voice has been silenced.
And in its absence, there is nothing to deny Barriss's claim. Some on the Council truly believe, others see an advantage in supporting him, and Barriss plots against those who oppose him.
The threat dies when Barriss dies.
He is too powerful to confront now.
The wrath must build before reaching pitch.
Your crew awaits you at your ship. They have been informed of these developments. Barriss means to force the Council to bow, but he believes you to be dead. That is our advantage. Return to your ship, and we will advise you what can be done to thwart him.